guys, how are y'all doing? I am back with the September / October Blu-ray rollout. Just to answer a question I know is going to come eventually. The reason I'm doing this as early as I am is because I already have the pickups that I wanted to get for October. So, no need to delay into the end because I already have everything I want for October. With that said, lots and lots of great deals. 90% of the pickups this month, or for this haul, were scored with some Amazon credit that I had because they kind of messed up a couple things, and they were good about giving me credit for those, and so yeah, Amazon is pretty good about that kind of stuff, so that's always good when somebody, you know, goes out of their way to make things right for you after, you know, they mess up, which mess ups weren't really a big deal, but I appreciate the fact that they gave me some credit for it. So 90% of this was actually bought with Amazon credit and no money out of pocket for me. And with that said, we're gonna go into it. I'm gonna start with the ones that I have not watched yet. Oh, and one more thing. Not having a job means having a lot more space on the table to sit next to me. So everything is now able to fit on my table. So you won't see me bending over to pick stuff up out of the bag or off the floor or something as much. So with that said, here we go. First, Rock and Kevin Hart, Central Intelligence. This is supposed to be really funny. Trailer is really funny. Haven't watched these ones I'm showing you first, so definitely this is going to get a review whenever it gets watched. Next, this is a blind buy. This is something that was recommended by one of my collector friends in a video that she put on YouTube. It is Selma Blair, Amy Smart, Giovanni Ribisi, Beau Bridges, and Jason Lee in Columbus Circle. Haven't ever seen it, haven't ever heard of it, but Allie recommended it, so picked it up. Plus, it was pretty much free. Next, this is a movie that I haven't seen in a long time, but I have seen it before. Be interested to see how it looks on Blu-ray. Tequila Sunrise, Kurt Russell, Michelle Pfeiffer, and Mel Gibson. Next, another one that I haven't seen in a long time, Nicolas Cage, Meg Ryan, City of Angels. There that is. Next we have another blind buy. This is Hugh Jackman, Jake Gyllenhaal, Viola Davis, Maria Bello, Terrence Howard, Melissa Leo, and Paul Dano in Prisoners. Haven't seen this one. Always wanted to. Actually, no. Wait, this is a blind buy. Yeah. Sorry, I get a little confused sometimes. This is a blind buy, but awesome cast, ensemble cast, it should be pretty good just based on cast. Next is a WWE Studios release, Dean Cain and Big Show in Vendetta. Now this one is one I've wanted for a long time, but have waited for it to go down in price. And then once I got all the credit that I got from Amazon, I was able to kind of pick this up for nothing. So really looking forward to watching this. And Becca, I know that you're wondering how come I didn't get the code, because when I opened it, I looked at the code, it was expired, so you would have had the code for this had it not been expired. Alright, next. Now these, I actually had to pay a little bit out of pocket for. These next two, I had to pay a little bit out of pocket for. Got the Complete Legacy of Frankenstein collection. That includes Frankenstein from 1931, Bride of Frankenstein from 35, Son of Frankenstein from 39, Ghost of Frankenstein from 42, Frankenstein Meets the Wolfman from 43, House of Frankenstein from 44, House of Dracula from 45, and Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein from 1948. Out of pocket, I think I only paid $5 for this. So, $5 for this, out of pocket, awesome for all that goodness. It's a Frankenstein collection. Same thing for this one. I think I only paid $5 out of pocket for this. It's the Complete Wolfman Legacy Collection. That includes the Wolfman from 41. Frankenstein meets the Wolfman from 43, so that's... that's doubled. House of Frankenstein, that's doubled. House of Dracula, Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein, that's doubled. Werewolf of London and She-Wolf of London. So, $10 total for two things that normally run $39 each. Next is WWE and Scooby-Doo, Case of the Speed Demon. I have been waiting on this to go lower in price, but then again, like damn near everything in this haul, I got all that credit, so I'll be able to pull the trigger. Gave Becca the code for this. Hope the kids enjoy it. These next two, I had to pull the trigger on. I actually had to pay like $60 for, because they were Disney Movie Club exclusives, and I got an email that said I was gonna wait for them for a little bit to go down in price, but I got an email that said that they were going into the vaults after October 17th, so I hurried up and pulled the trigger, and that would be, these may be, I think, the only two things I paid full price for anyway, so, that would be the original Jungle Book, Disney animated, and the Jungle Book 2. Okay, next is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Now, this, again, I was gonna wait on, but the credit made it possible for me to get it now, so. Looking forward to really watching this. You'll see a review for this one eventually as well. So that's Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows. Okay. Next is Warcraft. Same deal. Just gonna wait. Got the credit, so I can pick this up now. Looking forward to watching this. Don't know if I'm going to do a review on this one or not. I might, but as of right now, this is not a definite review for me. I am looking forward to watching it, though. X-Men Apocalypse is a definite review for me. This was not a get because I had credit. This was already on my list of pre-orders to get. This was pre-ordered before it came out. As was Purge Election Year. This was pre-ordered before any of the credit that I got, so I paid out of pocket for that. I paid like $20 for this, and like $15 for X-Men. Alright, now we're getting to the ones that I've watched. Iron Giant. This was awesome when I was a kid, and it's even awesomer now. Looks great on Blu-ray. If you haven't seen this, I definitely would recommend it. Next is a Screen Factory release, Midnight Run, with Robert De Niro and Charles Grodin. This is definitely cheese fest, but still, it's a good movie to watch if you want to kill time. That is Midnight Run, and that is the original artwork. Because this is a Shout Factory release, it does have alternate artwork, but I flipped it around and used the original artwork, so. The Jungle Book. This is the live-action Jungle Book. I have not watched this one yet. I don't know why I didn't put this in the one that I haven't watched yet, but this is eventually going to get watched and reviewed. So I'll put this down here with the ones that I haven't watched yet, because I forgot to do it when I did the original thing. Jean-Claude Van Damme in a John Woo movie. The original Hard Target from 1993. This is a cheese fest to end all cheese fest, but it's some great cheese, so awesome movie. Awesome to have it. Looks great on Blu-ray. And then there is Hard Target 2. Still a cheese fest, still great cheese, but it has nothing to do with the same basic thing, which I thought when I bought this that it's basically going to be two movies, same basic storyline. It's not. This one, I feel like, is actually better than this one. Oh, shit. It's actually better than this one, but that's just me. And it's very rare that a sequel is better than the original. Next is another Shout Factory exclusive. This is Bill and Ted's Most Excellent Collection. It is a 3-disc set. It is Excellent Adventure, Bogus Journey, and then a disc loaded down with special features. Now this, I'm not going to do a review on the movies, because I feel like everybody and their brother has seen the movies by now, but I'm going to do a review eventually on the extra stuff, so this is going to get reviewed eventually, but just for the extra stuff, because I think a lot of people will be interested about the extra stuff, and everybody knows the movies pretty much by now, so why review the movies if everybody knows them, everybody's seen them, and just about everybody loves them, so. But you're going to see the review for the special features disc in a little bit. Same thing with the Shout Factory select release of Roadhouse. I'm not going to review the movie because everybody has seen the movie. You know it's some cheesy goodness. It's Patrick Swayze. Just kick ass. My favorite movies. I'm going to do a review with a special features disc on this. And yeah, it's really good. It's really informative. I love the way that they do their special features discs at Shout Factory because they're really, really informative and let you know things about movies you may not have known. So. Roadhouse. Alright, Captain America Civil War. This was okay. I wasn't blown away by it, but it was definitely, it wasn't bad, it wasn't blow away, but it was good for what it was. I can't wait for the next, movie in the series. But this is definitely, not the worst I've ever seen. Next is, Now You See Me Too. With that awesome lenticular slipcover there. Now, this was just awesome because the med, I was just left with my mouth wide open through this entire movie just because the magic is so, so, so awesome. And plus, you know, Daniel Radcliffe joins the cast. So, awesome movie. Definitely looking forward to more of these if they do them, and definitely worth picking up if you can. This one completes my original Karate Kid set, Karate Kid Part 3. They could have probably stopped after 2, but they didn't. And this is what we got, but it's okay. It's not bad, it's not really great either, but it completes my set, and I'm a completist. It's part of my kind of OCD thing I got going on, but still, it's okay for what it was. Next, Great Match Comp, the history of the WWE Hardcore title 24/7. Great memories in this, great match comp, and just tells the story of the hardcore title. The 25th anniversary of Beauty and the Beast. This is awesome. One of my favorite Disney movies. Well worth it. If you can pick this one up, definitely do it. Next is another Shout Factory exclusive. This is a Shout Select title. It is a biopic for Elvis. It's a John Carpenter film, which surprised me. Stars Kurt Russell, and this is going to get a. This was a requested review, so. This is going to get reviewed eventually. I have watched it. I just have been so out of sorts lately that I haven't been doing much with recording. So, yeah. But that's Elvis. It's going to get reviewed soon. Next is a movie based on the Stephen King book, John Cusack and Samuel L. Jackson in Cell. This was... kind of meh for me. I mean, it was okay, but it wasn't blow away, which when I saw John Cusack Samuel, I thought, yeah, this would be good. It was just kind of meh for me, so that's Cell. Another WWE film release with Adam Edge Copeland and Lana in Interrogation. This is really good. It's basically your cheesy action movie, but it's still really good. And I definitely would recommend getting it out of a Redbox or Netflix or some shit like that. Next is the 30th anniversary Blu-ray book of Labyrinth, starring David Bowie. This movie is just better every time I watch it. Definitely glad to pick this one up. This was a pre. I paid sticker price for this too because it was a pre-order. But yeah. Yeah, basically, if you're noticing a pattern here, things I paid full price for were pre-orders from before I got all this credit. So, but that's Labyrinth. Next is The Conjuring. And after that is this one. Literally scared the piss out of me sometimes. That's The Conjuring 2. This is just, oh my god. Definitely one of the best horror movies I've seen in a while. Definitely worth seeing. My advice is go to the bathroom before you watch it though, because yeah, if you don't, you're gonna get the piss scared out of you. Can't wait to see if they do a Conjuring number 3, which they probably will. Next is Me Before You. Now, this is the movie that I recommended to Tony to watch, because it makes me think of her. Just because of the situation I'm in and all that. And I would recommend this to just about anybody. It's definitely one of the better romances I've seen. And it's based on the JoJo Moyes book, which I had never read before I saw the previews for this. This is a case where the book is not actually better than the movie. The movie is better than the book in this case. That's very rare. It's kind of like the whole sequel is better than the original thing with movies. Very rare. Next we have Everybody Wants Some. I think Dazed and Confused. Just an updated kind of version a little bit. So this is really good. If you like, you know, 80s throwbacks, this is really a great movie to watch. And this was actually a recommendation from Allie, who also recommended the movie earlier. So thanks for that. Next is another recommendation from Allie, Paddington. This is a kid kind of movie, but still cute, and I loved it, and you should definitely pick this up and watch it. And if you got kids, they should be able to watch this too. Awesome movie, Paddington. Alright, next is The Huntsman, Winter's War. I got this because I'm a completist. This wasn't as good as the original Snow White and the Huntsman, but it wasn't bad either. If you're a completist like me, pick it up. If not, it's not one of those you have to pick up right now anyway, so. Now, we're getting down to the nitty-gritty. These are my two PS de resistances of this particular haul. First, I'm going to show you, and these are both DVD releases, because they don't have Blu-ray releases. First one here is the complete series of Quantum Leap. Now, I loved this show when I was younger. This is a show that is completely ahead of its time, and I watched this, all 5 seasons of this, before I recorded this. Awesome show. I love that I'm going to be able to watch, pull this out and watch it when I want to go back. It's Quantum Leap. And last, but certainly not least, is the complete 30 movie Perry Mason collection. I haven't watched all of these yet, but I am working on it, and these are just as good now as they were when I remember watching them originally on TV. And glad to have picked this up. And like I said, I've got all this stuff basically on credit. So there's only like four things I paid full price for, and that was all pre-order stuff or stuff from Disney Movie Club. So I think all these pickups I probably paid a grand total of like $120. So yeah, that's Perry Mason. Great movies. Haven't watched them all yet, but I'm getting there. And with that said, that is it. This is the September and October Blu-ray haul. Appreciate you guys for watching this and hanging with me. Love y'all. Talk again soon. And without me, or without you, there is no me. I will go to do this. I love y'all. See you soon. Peace.